Hello, everyone, and welcome to the LinkedIn studio here at B2Believe. My name is Andrea Campbell. I am the Global Director of the Measurement Analytics Partner Team here at LinkedIn. And today we have Amanda Grant with us, who is the EVP of Partnerships at Choreograph. Welcome.
Thank you for having me.
In today's talk, we're going to have a nice chat about brands and marketers and how we adapt to the evolving privacy-centric world, finding that right balance between scale and accuracy and the applications of a signal-agnostic approach. So, Amanda, there are many strategies, as you know, and innovations for navigating the post-cookie world. With the disappearance of third-party cookies, what do you view as the biggest challenge marketers are currently facing, and how can they overcome them?
Absolutely. I think we've been talking about this for almost 4 years now, right? And we're closer and closer to that time and that date. So the biggest thing when we think about what that means with the deprecation of cookies is a loss of tracking and attribution as the key fundamental things that advertisers are trying to figure out now. I think it really does tend to gear towards the type of advertiser or client or brief, like what is the makeup of their audience that really impacts them in different ways. So if you have first party data, great. You really need to begin to dive in as an advertiser to think about sub-segmentation and how you use that within the privacy-centric concerns that are coming from markets that are GDPR dependent, CCPA is an example, and there's continuing to be more and more legislation around that. So it's almost like a lot of clients that have that place to start, it's a really good place to start. There are clients that are finding that they're lacking in the first-party data capacity, so they really need to continue to stretch. In addition to those advertisers that do have first-party data segments, where do you go and where is your makeup? And a lot of advertisers are looking to, I think, I don't want to say they're not net new to the advertising segmentation schema, but contextual targeting, looking into clean room exploration in terms of what means for them when applying first-party data, and then also thinking about expanding publisher relationships, so getting into the third-party data space. Do they have those relationships in place already? If not, what is it going to take for them to be future-proofed in an audience standpoint? Do they have like a full picture once you begin to see the gaps that are present once we do get into that post-cookie world?
Thank you. I think first-party data is a currency at this point.
Absolutely.
And marketers are spending a lot of time in this moment exploring the dynamics of leveraging different data types, right? They want to maintain privacy and then also make sure that their advertising is still effective. So the balance between scale and accuracy when shifting from contextual data to first-party data is vital. So how should companies approach that shift?
And well, I think scale and accuracy isn't necessarily net new to many advertisers and something that they've needed to balance for some time. In the age of consent, where you know older methods of collection and turning those into targeting attributes are going to be challenged, I think what advertisers need to think about is bringing marketing and IT and legal really close together on what is achievable. So thinking about your audience spectrum and where you can apply that in privacy-safe and privacy-centric solutions is going to vary from market to market, depending upon different types of legislation. There are some things that are, you know, blanket approved, and you're going to want to lean in on those if you're a global advertiser, if you're looking to really expand things beyond a local market instance. But I think the consortium of having more than just like a marketing team look at what's achievable from an advertising perspective needs to kind of meet in terms of logistically with IT what can be done, and that might be clean room type discussions, that might be looking at more privacy safe on platform type solutions, but getting those teams closer together to think about what that means executionally moving forward is going to be something net new that some of the more advanced advertisers are already beginning to put plans against.
I think that's really spot on. So we're facing some of that right now with clean room. A lot of conversations, a lot of different teams, making sure that things connect. So diversifying data sources. We know that to maintain robustness against signal loss is critical. And you've spoken about the importance of a signal agnostic approach in scaling data. Could you explain what that means just a little bit more and how it can help future-proof marketing strategies?
Sure. I think if you are an agency, an advertiser, a publisher, you really need to look at what is on the table in terms of data variety. So it's not one piece of data or one data segment that's going to be the answer. You need to kind of compartmentalize what your data strategy is and what those different types of data represent. So there's a lot you can do with first-party data. If you don't have it, what do you do to either build those types of strategies or leaning in on third-party data publishers, getting into contextual advertising? It's really looking at the makeup of what you have and what you can either license or acquire and segmenting those into a more data strategy forward approach. And then that's where I think it really is helpful to bring the marketers closer to IT, because then you start to get into logistical conversations of like what's achievable to make this like scaled and accurate through different protocols that different platforms or advertisers might require, or even legislation. So just thinking about, you know, data strategy, not so much an interest in behaviors, but the quality and types of data and segmenting that, and then having a plan to continue to enrich those pools or being able to gather more connections and partnerships to be able to enrich that overall data set together is really the winning strategy for what I call like a more data agnostic approach.
Thank you so much, Amanda, for sharing your data points with us and your point of view on the cookie-less world that we are all in at the moment. Cookies have deprecated. They've started to deprecate at 1%. And we're looking at the end of the year, seeing a complete deprecation. So these conversations are timely, and we hope you've enjoyed this session.